about to get into this shit just a moment. Y'all know how we work, man. Motherfuckers didn't even come prepared. We just be texting each other, yeah, y'all wanna record?
Already.
And then we just record. Uh-huh. That's it.
City been going crazy last week.
Toledo on one, boy. Toledo is on one. God damn.
Hey, man.
This is fucking gas. Good gas. It's Bobby, gas, nigga. This is gas. Man, ain't no fucking Bobby, bro. Stop.
Bobby.
Bro, stop
that's
saying
Bobby.
That.
I don't give a fuck. That's Bobby.
He focuses a little bit so they can hear us.
Hey, that's Bobby right there. Yeah. Buddy got out of prison and been on some weird shit.
And ain't no fucking Bobby, man.
Bobby. This boy on stage hitting the splits and shit, bro. Cutting up.
Doing, man.
No, that. Oh, no, I was about to say, it might not be. No, that's Bobby. That nigga got a microphone at home, bro.
Bro, yeah. That could be a whole different person, bro. No, bro, that's not Bobby, bro. No.
That's Bobby.
He
bro.
Ain't
look at him.
He ain't.
That's
he ain't,
Bobby.
Bro,
look
that
his face.
Is not no fucking Bobby.
Look at his face. That's Bobby.
Bro, I looked at his face, nigga. That looked like Big Bug.
Look, right there, on watch. Bobby.
Man, that ain't no fucking.
Oh, no, man.
That's not
Bobby.
That's not
it
no
might
fucking,
be Bobby, it might not.
Man, that ain't Bobby, man.
That's Bobby, man.
He ain't never acting like that, bro.
Acting stupid. No, this shit say some nigga named Big Boogie. Don't, man, get the fuck out of here. It is Big Boogie. Big Boogie live performing. Get free. Get goddamn free.
No, but I still see that nigga Bobby on some weird ass shit.
I did too.
But that's my dog.
And your dog a freak.
He a freak. Man. Didn't I just say that shit when you when you first showed me?
Like Big Boogie,
like
that's
Big Boogie, bro.
That's hilarious.
That's him, what?
He ain't never on that freaky ass shit,
Big Boogie on a
man.
Different type of time. That boy getting...
Bobby get a pass this time, bro.
I did catch me still doing some weird
shit. Yeah, look, bro.
That nigga he don't always get a pass.
That better not be no fucking Big Boogie.
It is him. It's his life performing. He was performing like Yo Gotti shit.
Yeah, very thing. I would've had
he was
to,
them
I'd have
niggas.
Had to cut that nigga performance like, hey, yo.
He was
hey, DJ.
Bro.
You got to go on.
He was off the jiggers,
yeah,
boy.
Freaking
floor
shit.
Nigga said DJ D-Rep.
Yeah, that's... I can't believe that.
No, bro.
And niggas out here gyrating and shit.
Niggas don't even... Bro, niggas not that. Bro, these niggas is weird these days. I see the nigga Quando Rondo bite his homie's shoulder.
No.
Bro, that's weird, man.
They be too close and shit.
Your only family
will steal STILL from you.
Yeah, my dog was slow.
Yeah, bro, you worried about everything but spelling.
He worried about everything but spelling.
That shit is unbelievable. There should be no fucking way.
Should be shot lighter. Niggas be rich and be stupid as fuck.
Yeah.
Hey, what be with these rich niggas, though? A lot of these niggas be wearing some
money.
Suspect shit.
There you go. You just answered it yourself.
You feel me?
What's up with these rich niggas? Money. Nigga, money.
Hey, but you think the niggas really be as rich as they portray, though? Because I know all these niggas can't be banned up like they show them, bro.
Everybody banded up.
Like gunning them? Yeah, they actually got it. Like,
yeah.
No, I ain't talking about, like, gunning. Like, them type niggas, little baby, I know them niggas eating. But I'm talking about, like, do you feel me, ooh. Like...
You gotta put a name on it,
cause they're
I mean, I can't put names, cause it just be like young niggas I be seeing on Facebook. I ain't never heard
okay,
their music
okay,
and shit.
Yeah.
But I'm saying like they be in the industry low key.
Yeah, it be they do be some little niggas that be dressing weird as hell.
I feel like a lot of them got the bag, though. I mean, like not as much as they actually could get. because they just wanted to get money. You know what I mean?
Them niggas got the bag because they just wearing all weird ass designer shit that don't match. They just throwing that shit on. Them niggas got a bag because they just blowing on weird shit.
No, I mean, like, a lot of that shit, like I said, you can see a lot of that shit be for front. I ain't gonna cap. A lot of that shit just be for that. Yeah, that's what, dang, motherfucker don't be having no money.
Everything be perception type shit.
Yeah, no, that's it though, but like, certain few motherfuckers though, where like, Young Thug, like, that nigga, he can put on anything. Nigga, no, he got that bread.
Yeah, for sure.
I ain't gonna cap, you know what I mean?
But do the money make that shit acceptable though, you feel me?
I feel like, everybody that's judging ain't really got it like that though. Ain't really got it on that level. So like that's why I don't judge.
That's what I'm saying. Like you don't know what you would do when that money get in your
hand. Exactly. You know that's exactly that. I don't know what I do.
You ain't never. You had $100,000.
Hell no.
See what I'm saying? You get $100,000, boy. You gonna get a little nice little. You not even a bubble, a nice little car though, and you about to go see what's up. What?
I'm talking like I'm not about to dress like Gunna and Young Thug. Though,
but you gonna dress. But you gonna fuck around and dress out the ordinary to somebody else that look like damn, bro. I wouldn't have wore that, but shit, nigga, you ain't got the money to get this shit.
No cap, me, bro. I never been that type of nigga though. It's like with the you feel me fashions and shit. Yeah. Bro, I don't care, bro. I throw on some motherfucking black pants or black tee, be cool.
Right.
Plus, when I'm rich, nigga. I'm about to be designing my own shit. You feel me?
Felt that.
No, it's like a lot of that shit though. Like I always fuck with that type of shit. Like you know, I sort of look back and see like I like not like that though, but like I always like wear like fitted jeans or whatever or shit like that with the little slit in me and shit like that. Like always had that little like you feel me? Because that's just the shit I like. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, and I don't agree with everybody be wearing and shit like that. You know, but it's them though. It's like. Y'all do y'all, you feel me? But it's like, if I get in there, I know somebody, like, if I get in the industry right now, you feel me? And I'm in the industry for 3 years now, and I'm just buying shit. Just anything now that I want to. We going out to the Chanel store and just buying shit. Like, fuck it, I'm going to buy something too. You know what I'm saying? Or fuck it, I'm going to rock this too. And then I actually fuck with it, though. I actually grow on me. You know what I'm saying? Shit like that. It's like shit. I fuck with fashion, though. I ain't going to care. But like I like to see women in fashion though. Like I like to see women dress. Like you know what I'm saying. Like good dressing women. Like I love that shit. Like if you know how to dress as a woman, bro, that is.
Man. When it comes to women dressing, I like a woman appearance. Period though, I like all natural shit. Like when it comes to a female, like I like natural boy. Like weed and all that shit cool, but like bitch, if you got an afro, bitch, rock your afro.
Yeah, bro, all that makeup and shit, that shit don't be.
No, some people need that shit though. I ain't even gonna.
Some people do, but it's like some if it's one of them what's it called, the Crunch Bar bitches. One of them Star Crunch face bitches.
Like that shit still a front, bro. Because at the end of the day, nigga, you got to take that shit off.
Right.
Exactly. So you feel me? Somebody gotta like the real you. Before you putting out that fraud shit, you feel me?
Yeah.
Did you anything?
Nope. Nope. Hell no.
Yeah, I ain't know if he was passing or not. All right, hey, shit. Face of this bitch was fucking.
I was like, oh shit. I just looked up. He said, nope. Damn.
Yeah, I ain't got to see how they passing them bitches like batons.
If I got a bitch like that, I think I'd dress like Ross or somebody.
I'm lying, dude.
I'm weak.
I be lying.
No, man, today is September 10th. 2K just dropped. So, ladies, I'm just gonna give y'all like three little things though, just to do.
Yeah, don't be going live and breaking them niggas' CDs and games and shit.
Yeah, y'all let them niggas be. Y'all let them niggas play their game. Me. Y'all let them niggas be. Niggas gonna be running throughout probably like from 10 o'clock at night to 2, 3 in the morning. Yeah. I know this.
Niggas making their little runs and they heard them coming back to the crib.
Yeah,
right
motherfuckers
now.
Ain't even
leaving right now.
Right now, like I said, like motherfuckers is catching up.
My shit download right now, nigga. I am not leaving for a whole month.
Yeah. I was seeing niggas with cheat codes talking about set your shit to New Zealand and that shit would download
it
last night.
No, it was real shit. People been changing their time zones and all that shit.
You know what I'm saying? People but yeah, like, no. Your motherfucking females, don't be putting on your statuses and shit. You feel me? You better have your nigga at home playing the game than when you play the game, bitch. You break this game.
Or you be sorry that you playing the game and you just
bitch,
be
why
all
would
us.
You break this game? And why? Now niggas, I gotta go buy a new one and you not getting shit and you about to be homeless, bitch.
Niggas that don't play the game, it's your time to fuck niggas, bitches.
Mm-hmm. On the real shit.
Everything.
On the real shit.
All your nigga playing nigga shit come through.
And
I was crazy. And I speak some every gamer, like, some niggas was like, nigga, bitch, go cheat.
Yeah, no, that, go, and I speak for every gamer when I say, go ahead, bitch. Like, don't do y'all thing. Like, leave me the fuck alone. Right now, I'm grinding 99. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit.
About what you doing right now. I'm cool.
You go ahead. Go ahead.
Just don't let it come back to me. I don't give a damn.
Right now, I'm engaged to this bitch. This game is 2K. I'm engaged to this motherfucker. I promise you. I'm trying to hit 90 fucking 9. You know, I'm not playing.
Maybe if I get down, I'll talk to you.
I promise. I'll have
maybe. Maybe.
No, it's what? What? 2K21 died down is what? Like right after, like, what, in like February it died down?
Yeah,
February, that would be the perfect time because what, y'all get y'all Valentine's Day shit? And you say, hey,
first
we're
of all,
turn
niggas
up.
Was playing 2K the other night and just the niggas just stopped playing that shit, like 2K21. Niggas just stopped playing that shit and just got deleting shit.
I shit you not, I was playing the rec game. I'm telling you, I had good points, good stats. I'm talking about it was a close game. As a matter of fact, I think we up by like 10. We up and everything, you feel me? I'm shooting five. I mean, hey, I'm shooting like 5 from 6 at the 3. You know what I'm saying? I'm hitting. Man, I took one little shot or whatever. They made my dude fade. I'm talking about I quit the game, closed the app, and deleted that shit. Everybody like, damn, you quit. Yeah, man, that shit ain't even on my system. No more.
Said, hey, 22
that shit is gone. 22 is out, bro. In a couple hours, I took my last.
Nigga, I didn't even know 22 came out today, nigga. I was just looking in the store. And the motherfucker just said, like, I'm looking for the pre-order thing. And it didn't say the pre-order. But nigga, I'm looking for the pre-order. Man, what's the day is? We all talk about the 10th. All right. Look at the damn game. That motherfucker said, come on, the 10th. I said, bitch, I'm about to buy this real quick. Oh, me? Well, I'm about to, I'm sitting in the house. Dang. What the fuck?
No, it's real shit.
And that's the safest spot to be right now. Oh, shit.
Yeah, right now.
Especially
it is,
with
boy.
The city going crazy.
The city is
here.
Going stupid. We didn't have. Rocky up Purge night, boy, them niggas.
Boy, be safe out here, man. That shit ain't no joke.
Real shit, though. Like, a lot of people, you know what I'm saying? A couple people I done grew up with, you feel me? Like, just, you know what I'm saying? Dead, you know what I'm saying? And that shit crazy because, like, I know, like I said, the nigga that died, you feel me? Just recently, you know what I'm saying? I knew him. You know, I actually went to school with him in 6th grade and shit like that. So it was like, I didn't know him like that, but it was on some shit like that, you know what I mean? But. Then there was a girl that ended up passing away. I don't know how she passed away, but she ended up passing away.
Yeah,
the city.
Shout
I just
out
talked
to
her.
Them families, boy. Prayers up.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck is going on with the city, though. This shit is crazy.
We always, it's like, nigga, Toledo get, like, little spurts and like in, like, certain parts of the year. Like, nigga, when it's about to, like, when the summer about to end, niggas is about to go stupid around this last little bit of month before it get cold.
All the time, though.
It's like, bro, y'all get this shit, like, on time every fucking year.
No, I ain't gonna lie, though. A lot of people were saying this summer about to be crazy. The summer wasn't as crazy as everybody anticipated.
Yeah,
man.
You know what it was? That nigga was still fucked up.
It was fucked up every year.
Niggas always say that shit. It was fucked up, but it was not as bad as...
I was thinking it was gonna be like, damn, I don't want to go outside.
Crazy is like you would think that it's gonna be crazy because niggas say that shit every year and every year, nigga, the summer be cool, it'd be a little fucked up situation like that, but it don't be nothing too hectic like, well, nigga, I'm not going outside today. Fuck that.
This year, bro, it was some young shit. It was a lot of young shit happening though. I said this year it was a lot of young like killings or death type shit.
Yeah,
where
either
a young nigga died or a young nigga pulled the trigger.
Like, you know, these young niggas, the youth is, nigga, this youth is horrible.
Right, we talk about niggas that's, they ain't even get to see 10th grade.
And it's like, nigga, when we was little niggas, niggas can't even find a gun. You will have one person out your group that got a gun, and that gun might not even come out the house until...
No, when I was little, I'm talking little, as to like, 10 or 11.
Niggas is fighting.
Niggas ain't, I'm talking about like, I real life thought the only people that had guns was like police officers at that point in time because that's how, you know what I'm saying, not often you hear about people getting shot. You know what I'm saying? Like, that shit was not often.
See, I didn't think like that because I had a situation. But, nigga, but you feel me? It wasn't like, I didn't see guns a lot, nigga, more than I see the motherfuckers now. Yeah. You feel me? I didn't see as many guns as it was, boy. Nigga.
What's the difference now, though?
Now you see everybody got them bitches, nigga. Your 13-year-old little cousin got that bitch with a 30 on it.
Social
like,
media.
Little cousin,
bro.
I got a big-ass dick on
it. Yeah,
I got a big-ass dick on that bitch, boy.
That's really crazy, though, because, man, like I said, people, like I said, when I was young, I wasn't, you know what I'm saying, the niggas didn't have that. Motherfuckers was athletes, you know what I'm saying? It was cool to be an athlete and all that extra shit, you know what I'm saying? So when people actually got coming out here with all these guns and shit like that, and they actually want to be a gangbanger or shit like that, want to make that shit cool, that was definitely like the change of everything, for real.
The shit, nigga, all the athletes is getting shot and killed, you feel me, or doing the shooting and shit.
Because athletes is gangbangers, though. All these athletes, they got, you feel me?
Yeah, they got some type of ties.
They been on that shit, though. Because look in the league,
No, they did. No, but at the same time, like I said, it wasn't really like that well known. Like, a lot of people wasn't doing that. Will was athlete, the big homies and shit, people out here, they making sure they on the right path. They not like, you're not about to be out here. Yeah, they don't look. A lot of people did that. Like I said, you look in the league. With the DeMar DeRozan motherfucker did that with him. With Dame Litter, they did the same thing with him. You know what I'm saying? It's like,
niggas got time. Them type of niggas don't come around too often.
I'm about to say, especially down in Toledo, that I know.
Them niggas is not here.
It might be a couple, but.
Because them niggas get a little nigga a gun.
No, I'm on some real shit. But when they think, you know what I'm saying? But so, I just feel like it's on our generation, though, to change that shit.
To try to change
it. To try to change the shit. Just be like, look, little nigga, like, hey, keep doing you. They see a talent in you, like, shit. A lot of people, some people's ass in sports, they need to pick up a pack. They need to be like, hey, fuck this, bro. Pick up a pack and get some money, bro.
This ain't gonna be you.
Yeah,
but this right here, you want to work? You want to work? Yeah. I got a pack.
Look, get some money.
This pack might just work for you. Mm-hmm. On me.
No, exactly. Though. A lot of people need it. I ain't gonna cap.
But if you got that talent to pick up a fucking ball, nigga, pick it up.
It's a lot of talent in the city that got wasted, you know what I'm saying? And,
most definitely. You're looking at it.
And no, shout out to the people that actually doing something with their shit, though, you know what I'm saying? Because that shit.
Nigga, I run a 3-4 and a 40-yard dash, man. Damn. No, I
didn't. Yeah, what the fuck?
That's fast.
Fuck, boy. I ain't no cap, bro.
Nobody ever
did. I wish I would have kept hooping, bro. Because I used to be one of the fastest fat niggas out there, nigga, my mama, bro.
I was hooping when I was young and I was short and shit. Like, I was like, that's me and Mook was down there the same height and type shit. So I wasn't even, I was chubby and shit. So then, you know what I'm saying? Once I got like 16 or whatever, I got to a growth spurt. I'm talking about, I grew overnight. It was like, like one of them, like, you laying in your bed and you feel it. Then, nigga, like, next day your feet hanging off that bitch. You like, what the
movie type, bro?
Yeah, that was like, shit.
I never had a growth spurt.
But I hit my growth spurt and shit. Like I said, we was the same height. Like I said, I woke up one day, I was just like, tall as fuck.
Yeah, bro, I don't know what the fuck happened, bro.
I was just hiding like the eighth grade, bro.
I ain't never grew. After I had the fourth grade, nigga, it was done. I ain't grow since the fourth, nigga. I've been this.
Yeah, you probably grew a little bit since the fourth.
Bro. That's it.
Yeah, no, that's
real
shit, though.
I haven't been, bro. What?
Nigga, I'll be up, bro.
Don't and then when it came to sports, nigga, the motherfuckers used to be like, low key iffy. Like, what you iffy for, bitch? You know me.
I'm about to really do that to you. But, like, yeah, no, that's what was, you know what I mean? Because, yeah, you remember, I had to. The growth spurt era, that shit was different.
Yeah, I was so confused. I'm like, boy, something wrong with my back. Mm-hmm. Oh,
my neck and my back.
Oh, hood, that motherfucker's not stretching. Why are these niggas just getting tall? No, I'm here.
No, my shit was fucking.
This blunt comes out.
Yeah, I had that in my pocket. I don't know. That shit game up. But fucking, yeah, bro. Nigga, I'm talking about when I was younger. I had no facial hair, no underarm hair, none of that shit. So I did not get none of that. So I was wondering what the fuck was wrong with me. I'm like, bro, what the fuck? Like, I don't got no facial hair. Like, still, like, nah, I still ain't got no facial hair.
Yeah, boy, first hair on ball, boy, you be like, whoa.
Yeah, I was turned. I ain't gonna
whoa.
Count. I was turned up.
Who the fuck do I tell about this one?
I don't remember that moment, though.
What?
I definitely do.
What? Nigga, you're not that old. We're the same age.
Yeah, I was frequently looking at myself. You know,
but, I had a beard since I was, you feel me? So it's like.
If I should have it at elementary, boy, I was happy as hell, too. Whoa!
And if you had a beard, like, well, that's fucked up, bro.
No, I ain't gonna say since I was little, nigga, but since I was in high school, like, probably like my. I guess I had facial hair since like 14, maybe 15.
What's like how you,
went to,
you went to
Burndale? No, I went to like charter school.
Okay.
Leak ass shit. Nigga, I used to run the school type shit. Like,
yeah, I went to all fucking public schools, boy. Yeah, I went to one academy. I went to Phoenix.
Yeah, I went to Phoenix. I used to rap with my teacher, nigga.
Oh, that nigga.
That let you know what type of school I went to, my nigga.
I definitely went to a ghetto ass school. It was like a K to 12. Yeah, mm-hmm. K-12, man. Yeah,
I had one of them, but it was separate, though.
Huh? When I went to Alliance downtown?
Oh, okay.
Like, it was K-12.
Is that where you finished elementary yet?
Huh?
Is that where you finished elementary yet?
Yeah. Yeah. That's when I did my, went to sixth grade or whatever. Because that's still elementary, right? That was elementary at the time. When I was in sixth grade. That?
Nigga, they turned Burndale from junior high to elementary.
Six to eight ended up being like junior high or something.
Yeah, they changed it to 6 to 8, and then I was like K-8.
Yeah, so, at one point it was everybody just said one school.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
I thought it was K-6. Yeah, but then they changed it to 6, 7 today.
Yeah, because Burndale not even a fucking junior high no more. That shit is elementary.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they changed a lot. The school
shit
system.
That shit came through 8 too?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Beverly on and shit. Man, Beverly was just the elementary. No, yeah,
they said fuck that shit. For all them kids in there, for all the kids in there,
all that shit got fucked up. Man, tore Libby down.
Real talk. And that was the year right before I was about to go there.
Y'all mad as hell I couldn't go to Libby, boy.
What did they close for? They like niggas just stopped going there or something.
No, it was definitely not a
I guess problem in that. It was a money thing with the motherfuckers that got money, bro. I don't know. The city just was going weird and shit.
The city
was because it's like, bro, that was one of the first schools in the city. That's the historic ass school, bro. Y'all ain't tear down Scott, nigga. Why the hell would y'all tear down this one?
Honestly, I feel like they took it down because it was too like ratchet, too ghetto. Like that school was like Cooley High.
That shit was like, wow.
Man, they could have fixed
but
that.
They could, yo, like, they could at least rebuilt that.
Yeah, they could have. They could have reinvented.
No, they wanted to split all the kids up. They split half of the motherfuckers that stayed on one side of the thing because. To Scott and the other ones went to Bowser.
Half the motherfuckers came to Bowser. We're talking about nigga. We was in a hall with like 13 niggas. Like, hold on, bro.
Yep. One half with this motherfucking Scott.
It was a lot. Excuse me. My bad, brother. Excuse me.
Hey, no cap, though.
It was a lot.
That shit was fun when it happened. But, like, nigga, the administration and shit, all that shit started changing. Like, got stricter and shit.
Because the shit was wild. Because all the motherfuckers over there that came over here.
And we was already doing dumbass shit over there. Yeah, so, nigga, then they came over here. We like, shit, join us, nigga. We about to fuck this shit up together.
They're switching our principal off that shit. Like,
that's when we got Miss
the lady.
Yeah, oh, man, I don't know her name.
He talking about the lady.
The lady.
Hell,
she has blonde hair, though.
The first nigga name was, I think, Principal Black or something like that.
Yeah. Oh, me.
And that's when school was fun, bro.
I remember. That's when we had red and blue days, nigga.
Bro, that's when school was fun, bro. All the shit that, like, the seniors and all that shit got to do before we left.
That shit was not fun. We did not do it, bro. That shit was not fun
once
at all.
Once they switched.
Them blue and red days was not fun, nigga. Fuck what you talking about, bro.
But since we're talking about school, bro, I was just watching something yesterday, and it got me thinking, bro, like some subject, bro, is not necessary to have tests to say you know that shit, because it don't matter in real life, like. History, bro.
Yeah, you
can make a nigga have a class, bro. But why do we gotta be tested about that shit and fail that shit and have to retake that shit? Damn. And it's not gonna help in real life, bro.
At all. I mean, I guess it might help you in real life because if a nigga
it depends on what you're doing
in your life.
Career, though. Like,
what career you gonna take though?
That's why. It's okay to have it. It's okay to get it.
Okay, not to test on it, but
yeah, you feel me? I shouldn't have an OGTs about that shit. I shouldn't have to have exams about that shit. Cause in a regular life, nigga, why the fuck do I need to know Washington Carver?
You right.
Or if he black, you feel me? You want to know? I can't remember, man. I'm blowing as fuck.
he black.
That's the peanut, nigga.
Yeah.
I don't like peanut butter, so I don't give a fuck. No disrespect.
You tripping?
Peanut butter cool, but I don't fuck with it like that.
But it's like,
I was gonna say George Washington, but you don't need to know that nigga because of a dollar. You feel me?
Yeah,
right.
Fuck
why
him.
Do I need to know the Emancipation? Like,
hell, I really don't know, but shit. I mean, like I said, Now, I don't think they should test on it, but they should go ahead and give you a little rundown.
Yeah, it's cool to know that shit that had a little excerpt.
Oh, me, because you might come across some shit that might be like, ooh, like, nigga, I should not do this.
When they telling us about, like, they trying to abolish slavery and all that shit, they telling us of a story, but who's to say they ain't capping about that shit?
Oh, yeah,
like, they flipping that shit around because it's black history.
Yeah, they tell you parts and bits of it. But I feel like, nigga, like, when it come down to history, I feel like the main thing motherfuckers, like, they do teach is that John D. Rockefeller nigga.
What's that?
The nigga that like created banks and shit, like how all the bank system. That's motherfucker.
Yeah, that's important.
Yeah, like how he like them niggas was finessing banks and like them niggas is up
but
there.
In real life.
But you feel me? Like that's
that shit don't matter because in school they not teaching you about how to put your money in the banks.
Yeah,
they teach you who came up with the shit.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Or they that shit, right? Can be teaching like, nigga, just don't go to them banks. Go to a whole black bank, my nigga.
If the world don't think black history is important enough to put in them tests and shit, history itself shouldn't matter enough. You feel me? Period. Yeah. Because real talk, black people came up with a hell of a lot of shit.
That the white man just go ahead and script that shit,
and
boy.
They twisted that shit. Oh, you feel me? Writing the story. You feel me?
That shit mine.
So why should that fucking matter? Now math, that's something that a nigga should be tested on, cause that's some shit that you really end up needing in real life.
Yeah, math, really, like, English, all that shit.
How do you feel about school in general, though? Like, what do you think about school?
School in general is necessary, but some of the curriculum is unnecessary. Because it's not really getting you ready for life. High school is not fully getting you ready for life. It's shit that you get in the world like, damn.
You know, it's basically telling you how to get by. How to become a civilian, basically. How to just to work. They're teaching you how to work, man.
I think I cheat that shit.
That shit, that's all it do is just teach you how to fucking...
Bro, it's really just...
It don't teach you how to make your own damn jobs and none of your own business. Like, it really makes you... It just teach you how to, you feel me, just get by in America, boy.
I mean, that's basically the thing of it. Like, school was invented just to basically train your mind or whatever and get you groomed for the real world. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. A job or somebody of a public service. You know what I'm saying? That's what it was invented for. That's what like they said it was for. You know what I mean? But it's a lot of hidden agendas is into it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, because it's like, was they really teaching us about the real world, nigga?
No, right. You know, that's funny. A lot of people say it's programmed. Me, I can't really talk too much on it because I don't know, you know what I'm saying, too much on it, so I don't want to sound dumb, but
right.
At the same time, like I said, a lot of people, like, I don't know. I'll
tell you.
Like, school, that's... I don't know, school, I feel like it's definitely important.
I feel like it's definitely needed.
You need school.
Because if you at home working 24 hours, who's going to teach your kids or who would have taught you if your parents was at work? Like, you need this shit most definitely so you can have some type of fucking common sense. But you feel me? It don't teach you all the way in life, though.
It teach you how to be controlled. That's what, you feel me, the main aspect that I got from it from kindergarten through eighth grade.
You gotta walk in line. Well, K through six, you have to walk in lines and shit, line leader, all that shit. But I don't, seven through twelve, though, I don't know. It could, I feel like they have a little leeway on it.
It's showing you how, you feel me, your teacher is basically gonna be your manager, your boss, or some type of shit.
Right,
But it's not, when you go to school, you never learn how to fill out an application.
Oh!
I didn't have that class.
I did.
Why is that not mandatory though?
Yeah, that is true, but I did have that. Some niggas be saying that shit, but I always argue with that. Like, nigga, I took two classes, nigga, from junior high and high school to know how to, you feel me, sign up for an application. What I didn't do was fucking a checkbook or checks or shit like that. You feel me? Like, they ain't teach us that.
I learned that shit, but I don't think I learned it in school.
And it was something else, like, dual math, but, yeah, like, applications, nigga, yeah, they taught me how to write down an application.
Yeah, definitely, because I remember, well, I did application in sixth grade, but I remember two years before that, when I was in fourth grade, we was doing, they was teaching us how to, like, write letters, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and do all the PayPals and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, PayPals and all the things.
PayPals,
like
PayPals,
so it was just... You know what I'm saying?
We did that shit.
So, I mean, they kind of was, you know what I'm saying, getting us ready to do some shit.
Did you learn, what the fuck was I about to say?
I didn't go to camp in elementary.
Nah, that shit was just some extra shit, man.
I don't know what the fuck they were teaching y'all there.
Yeah, y'all learned about opening bank accounts and all that shit in school?
I did.
That's what I'm saying, no.
I learned about banking. I had to learn all that shit on my own.
My mom had to teach me all that shit.
That's what I'm saying. Knowing your social security numbers and shit like that. They never explained in school that shit is important.
That's one thing, like open bank accounts, check, and that's a fact.
That's a fact. I never learned that on my thing. But,
yeah, no, I never learned that shit.
But like, I don't know because like I said, that is a personal thing. You know what I'm saying? So it's like for you to know your shit, like you know what I'm saying, to see if you know your shit.
Need it though. Like, why is right, it not
but,
like?
But it's so vital, bro. To like, if somebody get a hold of your social security, it's over with. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like you can't really teach that.
Yeah, you don't know if one of them.
You can't be like,
scammers.
Hey, tell me what's your social. You know? What I'm saying?
I'm not saying like no shit like that. Make that an assignment. What's your? But what I'm saying is like, in school, I never ever heard about the social security shit. Like,
oh, where?
That I could think of.
Oh, yeah.
You feel me? It's like, but you teaching us about Thomas Edison and shit.
Yeah.
Why does that matter? Well, I can just plug this shit in now. I don't really care that.
I don't fucking care.
You feel me? Because at the end of the day, I need to go make money so I can have that shit on. I don't need to know that he made that shit. Teach me how to go get this shit.
Yeah.
Like resumes. Y'all learn that shit in school?
I learned resumes.
Like how to make one and shit?
I learned that shit in my computer class. I learned that shit in seventh grade. Like that's crazy because some schools, nigga, now we find out like some schools didn't teach certain shit.
Yeah,
on me.
Yeah, no, and a lot of people got way different curriculums than.
Oh,
yeah. A lot of that shit was useless. Don't get me wrong. I'm gonna hit you with that. A lot of that shit was useless, though. A lot of that shit was, you know what I mean? But as far as history, I feel like if we got true history, anything, it'd be too brutal. So I feel like a lot of shit have to get watered down. You know what I'm saying? For kids, I guess. You know what I mean?
That's because probably the
only thing. A lot of this shit is brutal, bro. A lot of this shit is like the real truth to shit.
A lot of that shit, they gonna keep it PG-13.
Yeah, because even nursery rhymes, bro. Even nursery rhymes, it's brutal as fuck. It's like, damn. Really
get into the nursery rhymes.
If you can't show us the real thing, why do we have to learn it? And have to be tested on that shit to say that we smart enough.
They just want to train your brain.
That's my thing.
That's exactly what I get from. They just want to train your brain to know if you know what I'm saying, can retain information. You know what I mean? And that's what I get from it. I guess I wouldn't say because it didn't never really feel like a jail to me. Like you know what I'm saying? Like a lot of people be saying that though. You know what I'm saying? And I don't like when people be like, oh yeah, like. That shit feel like a prison. It's not, though, you know what I mean? Because in prison, they not trying to teach you shit. You know what I mean? There's a lot of teachers that be like, I'm still getting paid. Like, I'll wait for y'all to talk and stuff like that. But at the same time, I know I didn't talk to a lot of teachers crazy. And I knew they would teach, they were trying to better, you know what I'm saying, better educate me, you know what I'm saying, on anything. And I would just be like, ah, fuck it. You know what I mean? But like, shit. A lot of teachers be like, fuck it, I don't give a fuck, I'm getting paid anyways.
Yeah, I had a lot of them too.
Yeah, so, I don't know.
I had a lot of them too. Especially if you had the teachers I had, I ain't gonna lie, nigga, I was in behavioral classes, nigga. Not dumb ass people like, I ain't gonna say dumb, but people that were like really special, I wasn't in them, nigga. We had special teachers, nigga, that, boy, we had some badass kids in our classes, boy. Yeah. Oof. Yeah, and they will cuss you the fuck out. Some of them niggas didn't care about fucking, teaching shit, cause nigga, soon as we come in, it's like nigga, they on defense mode. Like, what the fuck is he about to do today? Promise you, they was on us, boy.
Like, I know this is off topic, but I want to get y'all take on it. Drake, you know what I'm saying, Kanye West, they both dropped their shit. Which one of y'all think better? And just all the way, you know what I'm saying, honest, no bias. You know,
to me. Mm-hmm. They two different type of albums, bro.
People keep trying to rate it,
but you can't rate an R&B up against, like, the nigga, that was like an inspirational damn near gospel album, like, kind of like what Snoop did.
Yeah.
But Snoop really went church.
No, yeah,
Kanye
yeah.
went, like...
Ye went...
Yeah, borderline church, but it's not fully church.
But yeah, just like, you feel me? Yeah, more musical type.
I haven't listened to
it. It's two different.
No, I haven't listened to it.
To neither one? It's two different feelings of music, you feel me?
Yeah.
Like, I'm a musician, bro. I do that shit. So,
which one do you like better? Just based off of that, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, which... I know you can't really compare them to say who's better, but which one do you enjoy more? I mean, and this is all your opinion. You know what I'm saying? There's no wrong
answer. My opinion just depend on the mood. Like, if you cool... Y'all know who the Cray is?
Yeah.
Like, to me, this is like asking, like, who better, nigga? Or which album better, nigga? The K-Camp album or the Cray album? Because it's like two different types of,
right.
You feel me? Which one you gonna put on?
But no, he's saying, though, which one you like better.
Yeah, which one do you enjoy better?
I know the question. I can't answer it, bro, because it's like...
Because I ain't gonna lie, I heard a couple tracks on Kanye shit. I don't think I heard... No, I probably heard like one track on his shit. I think it was that what the fuck is it called? That jail shit.
The jail?
Yeah. Yeah. I think that was the only track I heard.
Yeah, that jail hard and that
Jay-Z
life is life of the party, boy. And I ain't even gonna cap, bro. Did you hear Andre 3000 verse on that?
I heard that one too. I
heard the song.
He went dumb. I did hear that one too.
Bro.
I do gotta go listen to that shit.
Bro, when I tell you, bro, he went crazy. When I first heard that shit, bro, I'm talking about back to back wasn't even a word. I'm talking about I kept replaying that shit.
No, yo, he was really talking some shit.
What's your answer, bro?
Yay. All day, yay! I fuck, bro. That. I don't fuck with every song on there, but yeah. I know where he at in life. You know what I mean? And I respect, because I know how he was with his mom. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I know how much of a toll it took on him. I'm not being biased just because of that. I just like the music a lot better than what Drake. You know what I'm saying? What I got from Drake.
Yeah.
And that's it. And Drake gotta live up to a high ass thing because he can't never get back to Take Care. What was the best album to me? That Take Care. So that's that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I
don't know. You know what I'm saying? And I, like I said, I'm going with Ye.
I'm a big Kanye fan too. Like I feel like that nigga's a genius, bro. A creative genius, musical genius, bro.
Yeah.
So that's why I can't even. I'm not even going. I can't put nobody up against Ye, no cap.
Yeah.
Like it's niggas up there with him, but I'm not. Bro, that's I don't entertain it.
He goes stupid for sure.
Yeah, man. Like I said, and once he popped on, you know what I'm saying? Yay shit. And once Andre 3000 popped on Yay shit, man, that was solidified for me. It was over with. Because like I said, it was like he only had like a minute and 40 something seconds on that fucking thing.
Yeah, I gotta go listen to that shit now.
Boy, when I tell you, bro, I'm like three. Bro, that's Andre 3 stacks, boy.
Crazy,
yeah.
Andre 3 stacks.
Boy,
that was Andre 3.
All three of them. He was talking crazy on that bitch, bro. And it's like, bro, and that's the type of music that I grew up off of. You know what I'm saying? Just the little beat on it and all that. I grew up off that sound, so you know what I mean. And my nigga said, I told Drake, don't play with me on GD. Hey, and he sent that message to everybody. Hold on.
I need to hear you say that,
hold
though.
Hold on. Yeah.
I can play
it right after the
that shit hard.
I'm playing right after the
that shit.
And the fact that he had that shit at the thing playing,
man.
And Kanye in a different bag.
He in a different bag, but bro.
The thing about Kanye, what I will say, bro, is the Donda shit, that shit kind of creepy to me. I understand the concept of what he was doing, but that shit hella creepy to me, bro.
You said what?
The first song on the album, the Donda chat, they saying that that's his mom's last.
Oh, yeah.
That's creepy as fuck to me. I don't want to hear that shit. Yeah, no disrespect.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. But that shit.
Nah, sometimes some of that shit, everybody send chills to down a couple people's.
You feel me?
And that's what did to me. Like I don't know. Like a lot of people say it's a fucking like it puts you in a trance or whatever.
I don't know about that shit.
Yeah, people, the conspiracies and shit. People like they put everybody in a trance and all this extra shit. Like bro, no, it's not nothing like that. But
you know what I mean?
It did give me chills though, only because it was like damn. You know what I'm saying? Like if that was his mom real last, you know what I'm saying, heartbeat, like that shit, it'd just be crazy, you know what I'm saying? So, I don't, like I said, that,
That part is the crazy.
That's the creative genius, though. Because who does that?
Exactly.
I'm not fucking with it.
Yeah.
But that shit is out. You feel me?
It's out there. That is out there.
The whole, bro, his whole last listening party, that whole
thing. Yeah, that whole thing. He built his house. He built his childhood home.
Nobody's doing that.
Nobody's doing that shit.
Nobody's doing that.
And burnt that bitch down.
He had 3 listening parties, bro.
Yeah.
Crazy, bro. In a pandemic, bro.
Yeah.
That's the craziest part, nigga. We still in the pandemic, bro. You just pulled that shit off, bro. 3 times.
Yeah, he's different. He is different, bro. Like Drake, he pulled up and he got Kawhi in his video. But no, nigga said he got Kawhi in his video. But Drake, he definitely, like I said, he funny as fuck. He more of like an Adam Sandler of the rap game, I would say.
He get his point across,
definitely.
Ain't nobody, bro. Drake is on a different level, and Kanye is on a different level.
Exactly.
Niggas don't even fuck with Kanye. He do this shit by himself, and he's Kanye.
Yeah.
Drake is the industry nigga. Like.
No, exactly that. Like, so, it's like, I don't even know what a good thing for this to be. Like, it's like being like, put. You know Snoop Dogg ain't good on every album. I mean, on every song.
Yeah.
Sometimes he's like, hey, bro, you know what I mean? But come he on, get off because he's Snoop. You feel me? A lot of motherfuckers like, that's Snoop. He in a different, you know what I'm saying? He in a different bracket. So anything he put out, motherfuckers like, hey, that's Snoop. I fuck with it. You know, period. You know what I'm saying? So it's just, I feel like it's going to get to that point for both of them. So it's like, oh, that's Ye. Or that's Drake. You know what I'm saying? That's, you know what I'm saying? He his own thing.
Tom Brady back at it.
Yeah, Tom Brady done won.
We're going ahead and go back on to these sports.
Hey, and I'm not going to cap, though. Shout out to Dak Prescott because after coming back from that injury,
I'm talking about, you can ask this nigga, I do not like
the Cowboys. And I hate the Cowboys.
I hate them niggas, bro. But
hate them.
Dak did put in some work, bro.
Dak went crazy.
You gotta get flowers when you do,
bro. Yeah, bro, that boy went crazy, especially against Tom Brady on opening night. He went crazy.
That was big ups to Dak, though, because he did go stupid on me. But niggas knew it was over because they scored so quick in the fourth. They scored too quick.
As soon as they scored, I said they scored too quick. Because
it
Tom
was,
Brady,
one, like,
they
one,
put the camera right on Tom
yeah,
Brady.
Like one,
wait,
bro, he was like, one, like, one, like one, literally, it was like 140 something on the clock. The nigga just got the looking at the time.
Yeah,
like,
he got just looking at
like,
him
like, damn, it's over with.
They just grabbed his helmet. I'm like, oh, man.
Nigga, that nigga's dangerous.
For the last couple plays, he got throwing it at the motherfucking cheerleaders. I'm on this shit. Throwing this shit.
Yeah, he was darting at that bitch.
I said, what the fuck? He was trying to hit one of them bitches in the head.
He came home with nice looks, bro. That nigga know what he doing, bro. That's it.
No, Tom Brady, that nigga crazy. He fuck around, might play until he 50.
Dad'll be stupid. Dad'll be stupid, boy.
He's 44 years old. Might be 45.
Yeah, as long as he ain't getting no
five more years.
If
a lion can protect him for 5 more years like that,
but
that's a 17.
You see what he said,
17 games. And
he said he was chasing like Jordan ring numbers, bro.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't give a fuck about no other NFL quarterback numbers.
Yeah.
How's you chasing a nigga in a whole other sport ring numbers, bro?
How much he got now?
Six.
Yeah, he trying to go for second right now.
He about to pass that, bro.
And hey, you see what?
Probably not this year, but he gonna pass that, bro.
What's my man that just got fired? Newton.
Oh, Cam Newton.
Can y'all see what he said to the press or somebody?
I didn't.
Talking about the reason that he got fired is because he was gonna be a distraction on the sideline or some shit. Because he wasn't starting. I'm paraphrasing it, but in so many words, like, nigga, they fired me, nigga, because if I was sitting there on the sideline, nigga, I was going to be distracted from the nigga playing.
What?
I don't know what he meant.
I don't even understand that one. You a grown-ass man.
Let me find that shit, make sure.
Honestly, dog, I got rid of him, too, though, because, like I said, he's 32 years old, and we got...
He had a fucking attitude of a diva, boy. On me, like, what the fuck is wrong with you, son? What's going on?
Kid? And he only signed a 1-year deal last year, just resigned for a 1-year deal. Of course, that you're like, fuck it, bro. Had a little money, go ahead, bro.
Somebody gonna pick him up, though.
I don't think so. Because who gonna need him?
Who the fuck knows? Who the fuck knows? I'm telling you. Somebody fucking gonna use that nigga as a backup.
Man, he could have come to the Browns, though, Baker Mayfield. They may feel that.
Here you go. My bad. Nigga said the reason that they released me was because indirectly I was going to be a distraction without being the starter. Just my aura. That's my gift and my curse. You feel me?
Hey, basically, I don't know. Video's gonna be all over New York, but the fans is gonna.
Yeah, I don't know how he would have been distracted, but you like a badass kid in class.
You feel me? Basically, he's saying dog wasn't good enough or something that they gonna be focused
they
on.
They just drive to the good quarterback. Like, it ain't no point even having
him. Mac Jones on there? Yeah. That's
crazy. There's no point even having him. Not even gonna count.
He was just about to be the man, though. Like, he was right there.
There's no, like, he was a man. He had his chance last year. Last year, he was a man. He started there last year with the Patriots. Didn't do shit.
No, I meant, like, football career, period. Like, when he was about to win the Super Bowl at that point. Yeah. He was it, nigga.
Shout out to Peyton Manning, by the way. You know what I mean? Get that ring. But, yeah, because, you know, that's the best quarterback of all time in my eyes. But, you know.
So, hey, can you look up the games real quick? Let's go ahead and do some predictions on those games real quick.
Yeah, no.
Then we can double back and see where we're going to go. Because I know my realm, we're going to kill Chicago. That's all. We're going to go right down Chicago, Mom. Who your favorite thing?
Football. I don't really give a fuck.
Oh, damn.
I just watch that shit, you feel me?
Felton.
That shit.
Niggas be getting hurt. You like one of the niggas that watch just like the hitting. You gotta watch
it. I just watch that shit to watch it. All right, the Seahawks and the Colts. Who you think got that? I think Seahawks have to come out and get that. Like, okay. I don't know. Cheating allegations against Russell Wilson.
He'll be fucked up.
He about to go crazy. He about to speak through the ball.
I don't even know who the fuck.
He played
the quarterback
yet?
Over there in Indianapolis.
Honestly, no. Me either.
I really don't. I'm about to think of Cam.
I don't know. It depends on what type of nigga he is, though, for real.
We go, like I said, I'm still good with Seahawks only because of allegations brought against him. He ain't trying to lose his queen's here. He got to ball out.
Hey, what if he really did that, though?